Hi, here are the Matrixers again. And today with a likable Jonathan and the attractive Shiva. Exactly. Our really exciting topic today is consciousness projections. A little mishap happened to us today. I am in the body of Shiva. Well, and I am in Jonathan's body. The whole thing went a little wrong, but don't bother much. Correct? Or Shiva? Yes, Jonathan. Do we want to get started? Yes. Then let's get started, Shiva. Yes. See you soon. See you soon. Yes, as you can see, we managed to get back into our own bodies. Projection of consciousness, this is our today's topic. We are doing this for the current occasion. I recently had a dream about consciousness projection and how easy it is. And so we thought, let's make a topic about it, right? Because it's really exciting and offers a sea of possibilities, as you can see the sea behind us so beautifully. Yes, the projection of consciousness mainly concerns the shifting of consciousness in an object or in another person or also in an animal or a completely different being on a very distant planet. It also works. You can't imagine that like remote viewing. With remote viewing, you simply go to distant places with your consciousness. But you're not really there with your consciousness, but you only look at distant places. You can experience this well and in a hypnagogic state. Then suddenly you see none, I know strangers, how they do something. Or on another planet, you see aliens, or you're just somewhere. So you're not really there, you only see it. That means it's like on a monitor, on your cocoon in front, on the monitor, the picture is simply changed, so to speak. You can train that too. At first you only see people, then you can capture the picture, then you can even move around and look around, so it's trainable, but it's not consciousness projections. The projection of consciousness is so that you go out of your body with your consciousness and suddenly transfer over. So it's also amazingly easy, as I've seen. I would say rather on the middle astral level. In any case, it looked very strange there, like an alien planet. You thought that could have been the middle astral plane because they have spores that I do will describe you in a moment. I was there on a bleacher and they have a spot there, and this spot is really funny. It's not like a soccer field. The grandstand was on one side, like in a theater. The large playing field is in front of the grandstand. Yes, there were a lot of people or beings sitting on this platform. I haven't looked around closely now, and they all watched the ball. The players shoot the ball. I thought to myself, what is that? What are they doing? It doesn't sound that exciting somehow. The game is actually that you have to be projected awareness into the ball and then shoots across the huge field. And then one being said to me, go ahead, shift or project your consciousness into this ball and then shoot across the field. I thought, okay. But then suddenly, zack, I'm out of my head. My consciousness shoot out of my head into this ball, then I flew across the field. And that really feels like out of body experience. Then you really fly and you also have the feeling of flying. And it was super easy in any case in a dream or where I was in this reality. Yes, and that's their sport. They just shift their consciousness into this ball and shoot across the field. It was very funny. I don't know what else they are going to do with it, because then I was out of the dream again. But I've seen how easy this projection of consciousness is. You can really use it to project anywhere, project your consciousness into foreign worlds or even into the free universe. You can actually, theoretically, if I really saw that, wake up in your real reality. So a lot is really possible with the projection of consciousness. It happened to me by mistake last year. We sat and drank coffee and suddenly I thought to myself, I'm Jonathan. At that point, it was not quite clear to me what had happened to me there. And then I thought, oh, we're one. I am Jonathan and I am me. Oh, and yes, now I know that was a consciousness projection. I was suddenly in Jonathan. What we did earlier in the introduction has actually already happened. And it was just a quick change. Zack, I was Jonathan. Your part. You may. And now, dear people, good Jonathan. So the projection of consciousness is an amazing ability because you have a part of your consciousness projected into another living being or object. When I first saw a consciousness projection that was normal when awake, I concentrated on one bird. And then I tried to shift my consciousness into a bird. One should not imagine that now that one is completely 100% in the bird. Rather, it is only part of the consciousness that is projected there. And when I shifted my consciousness to the bird, I was amazed at how easily I felt there. And I literally hovered over the floor when I moved as a bird. So then you had a bird's eye view. Yes. That's the way it is. So I had a bird's eye view, but from the ground, because the birds then sat there and pecked around a bit or looked for something. And then I was in the bird. And that was really a very interesting feeling, especially when the bird started and flew away. So that was pretty impressive, because at the moment I felt this power that came from him. How he then lifted off the floor. So my breath is right at that moment. Yes, what was my experience with consciousness projection? So I have experienced consciousness projection more often. So once I found that very interesting, or happened to me more often, that when I was watching films, I suddenly shifted my consciousness to the actor in the film. An experience in which I watched a film in which someone was sitting on a bus was practically noteworthy in a standing bus, and the protagonist was waiting for someone there because he wanted to meet someone there. And then he sat there on the bus and was just waiting for his friend who was just about to come. And then suddenly my consciousness was in the actor within the film. So it was interesting that the action was no longer compliant with what I had perceived from it. Because the moment I was in him, I could understand him telepathically, so to speak. That is, he had his hand on one of the seats, and they were leather seats on the bus. And then I noticed or felt very clearly what he was thinking at this moment. He thought that the leather smells very strong, and he didn't say that in the film. Or it wasn't the subject of the film to talk about the leather seats. And also that he felt that the bus smelled unpleasant from the strong smell of the leather. So do you think he thought that while the scene was being shot and you received it telepathically? Exactly, that's how it was. Once that happened to me at Columbo. You all know Columbo. The commissioner or Inspector Columbo in his old trench coat. He always solved the most difficult cases. For example, I have mind awareness shifted to the Columbo. And that was pretty funny, because then I suddenly became aware of the film set. So completely independent of the plot within the film, I felt or heard how he thought, yes, that's the best way to look at the camera. or I hope I'm right in the camera, and we do all of that for the film and the like. So all the thoughts that weren't even a topic in the film, just the thoughts he had about the film and about his role and text. And so it was completely independent of the plot. And I find that very interesting that he just thought about it. It also happened to me that everyone in the film really did as if they were playing these roles. I could then clearly perceive that. I mean, we all know that the actors in the film play for the audience. But it was there that I could perceive the actor's thoughts, and not the thoughts of the role that was played within the film. Yeah, that's exciting. Well, I didn't receive any telepathic messages at the ball, but I also already talked to people who, for example, have shifted their consciousness to a blackboard. And then they were a mathematical equation. Oh yes, I know the person, I was there. Yes, you were there, right. Yes, that was at your workshop, exactly. At my workshop, there was a woman who was talking that when they shift their consciousness, they mostly always come in pretty irrational or projected unusual objects, like a math equation on the blackboard, for example, and that's very exciting, I think. Or in the DNA. Or did she tell you something? Anyway, it was very, very exciting. Yes, exactly. Or in the microcosm, she was once. Yes, definitely has a great potential, I think, because if you look at it the other way around, and not projected consciousness, but stops projection. So if you realize that you can project your consciousness into every object and being, then you realize that you are projecting. But what if we stop projecting? When you realize, where are we? Then you realize where you are here. And when you stop projecting, wouldn't you just be in the egg or in real reality? That would be a very exciting question for me. And if you are wondering what we mean by the egg, watch all our other videos. We explain that often enough. Yes, I found it exciting how easy it is. So at the moment, I had completely shifted my consciousness into that ball. I was no longer in my body, but really felt like I was only in the ball. But that also offers really interesting opportunities, I think. In any case, it was super easy to shift consciousness into the ball and no longer being in the body. I thought it was easier than out-of-body experiences because you don't have to lay down, fall asleep and vibrate. Well, you know that, but you were there within a second, zack, in the ball. So over there. Yes, that happens very quickly. So it's just amazing how quick and easy, zack, and there you have the full possibilities. You can go on an adventure and discovery trip far outside of our matrix system. You can go anywhere with your consciousness and look at everything. You can empathize with others if you want to. When you go into another being and want to explore, how is that? What is wrong with him? That would be on our level now, or somewhere else, to distant planets, solar systems or galaxies. Everything is possible with the projection of consciousness. Or I also remember a friend when I was 4 or 5 people at the table, and suddenly she saw a silverfish running around on the kitchen table. And suddenly she shifted her consciousness into the silverfish and could see from the perspective of the silverfish on the kitchen table. And then she told us live how it was at the moment. She must have been inside the silverfish for a minute or two. And then I asked her how she would perceive that. And I found it exciting that she just replied, from the perspective of the silverfish, all the items that were just on the table, like bottles or milk bottles and other objects that stood there, were like a city for the silverfish through which the silverfish moved. with skyscrapers. And it was also very interesting when I asked, yes, and how did you perceive us sitting around the table from the perspective of the silverfish? And then she said, yes, you weren't there. There was only a fog outside the table, nothing else. That means the silverfish couldn't look that far, so to speak, so he couldn't see us sitting around the table, and I find that very interesting. That apparently so small creatures may not be able to perceive humans as a whole, but only a diffuse fog or the like. And I also got involved in a film, for example, reminds, I think, what was his name? The Incredible Story of Mr. C or something. I do not know it anymore. Anyway, that was a scientist who somehow discovered something with which he could reduce objects. And at some point he applied it to himself, and then it got smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. Afterwards, it was so small that it almost entered the microcosm. Interestingly, from there he only noticed a fog and could no longer see our realities beyond the fog. That's why I find it very exciting when you look at our sky, for example. If you just imagine, this is a philosophical mind game, for example. We are currently in a microcosm and perceive the sky. That means the sky can be seen somehow like this fog that the silverfish saw. This means that people cannot look beyond a certain size and thus maybe only recognize the sky. Yes, it's very exciting. So I found a very interesting thought that came to my mind. And yes, I also have ants considered. Whether ants can perceive humans as a whole? Maybe they only see a shoe sole that runs over there. Or maybe they only notice a large shadow. So I think there might be something there. Yes, it happened to a friend. Okay, maybe he accidentally took one or two moves from a joint. By mistake. Anyway, then a cat was sitting on him and he just looked at it and suddenly he said, huh? I can see myself from the cat's perspective. I think that was also extremely exciting. Yes, I think so. Yes, something like that happens. Yes, I also find it very exciting. So, to see yourself from an animal's perspective, if that is possible, so cats can probably see us then? Yes, as a whole. So cats can do it. But with small animals or insects or something, I'm not entirely sure how they perceive that. Whether they have the ability to perceive people as a whole. So the whole body. Maybe they only notice individual parts or maybe nothing at all. Yes, it can be good. You could almost think that certain size differences were separated. At least perceptually. You can think about it. Perhaps you have also had similar experiences through consciousness projections that have arisen spontaneously or who maybe accidentally got a substance on your sandwich and didn't know anything about it or the like. You can have a look at yourself in your memories that you still have there. And maybe there is one or the other who has a similar story to tell. Maybe you can deliberately shift your consciousness. So you've already trained that, because that's a learnable skill. Maybe you've already trained that, maybe you got the ability and do that every day. then we would be happy to receive tips and tricks. But the way I saw it is relatively easy to learn. You focus, so I have myself focused on the fact that I'm really in the head, so I'm really in the midbrain, and then I just switched over. It was totally easy. How exactly that worked now, I'm not sure. And the other times was more accidentally. Only there was intention, but the technology remained to me how I did it. But in everyday life, it is quite difficult. So I trained it like this. I always imagined pictures. So paintings, pictures that hang somewhere in the room, or posters that were found on the walls of people. I always trained that. I faced it. And it is best if it is a kind of landscape photo, or a landscape where maybe a mill can be seen on it, brook, forest, sky, and so on, or where maybe there is an animal somewhere, maybe a sheep or a cow or a deer, really classic art pictures. I found it the cheapest, so the easiest. And then I presented myself there, and me imagined that I would then be in this landscape, that I imagined I'm standing there in the meadow, or I stand next to the mill, or next to the wooden hood, or my consciousness is at the moment in the stack. And how does the deer perceive? How does he perceive his surroundings? So that's how I trained it. And then I managed to shift my consciousness into the object within the image a few times. And that's really exciting to experience it like that. I have another exciting question, namely, if you practice this with your mirror, the reflection that's an alternative reality of yours. So when you look in the mirror, you don't really see yourself, but actually an alternative reality. If you shift your consciousness there, are you in an alternative reality and can you stay there? Maybe then your consciousness changes from your body to the reflection, and then when you're on the other side, you realize that you are looking in a mirror, and then you stay over there. Shiva, just like that, just like that. So if you have a birthmark on the left, then we probably have it on the right, or yes. Anyway. Yes, another way you can learn to project consciousness is the incredibly brilliant technique of dissociation. We do not want to go into this in more detail now, because we have already made 3 really long and detailed videos about it. There is the dissociation, which is of course only a small part of the whole topic, but dissociation is the most valuable technique for us that you can learn, and that ability is, as you tell me, our superhero's abilities in this everyday reality, because you can really accomplish everything with it, from consciousness projection to out-of-body experience, dissolving ego, in alternative realities change, and gain insights of all kinds. And that's because we really think it's so awesome, are currently doing an online workshop about it, and of course we want it also make available. This will be another 2-day workshop, probably like that for 10 hours. We are not sure yet what comes out of it, because that extensive and becomes such a complex subject, but it's worth making that too, and to learn and train, because so you can achieve anything. And if you are interested in this workshop, then write to our email address, which we put in the description below. Register now and we can let you know when our course will be finished. And since we are already talking about advertising, our small online course, Get Out of the Matrix, is done. At 28 hours of material, there is also a small video with a little more insight, but at www.matrixer.com you can take a look at it, and if you're interested, take part in our workshop. Really, people, be there. Yes, that was our topic today, consciousness projection. If you have suggestions, tips, tricks, or have anything else, write it in the comments and subscribe to our really cool channel. And do you have anything else to say?
No.
Okay, bye then. Ciao.